Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. My dear respected elders, brothers, sisters, and the viewers of the Daily Reminder Network, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, wa usalli wa usallimu ala ashrafil anbiya'i wal mursaleen, nabiyyina wa habibina wa qurrati a'yunina Muhammad ibn Abdullah, alayhi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi afdalu salati wa atammu taslim, amma ba'd. As always, we begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is our creator, sustainer, nourisher, protector, and curer. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower His choicest of blessings and salutations upon our beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions, and all those who tread upon his path with utmost sincerity until the day of Qiyamah. First and foremost, I admonish myself and then all of you all present here to adopt a life of taqwa, and that is to adopt a life filled with the fear and the consciousness of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if we wish to attain success in this world as well as the hereafter. May Allah the Almighty make us all from the people of taqwa. Inshallah ta'ala, for tonight's heart softener, we will be touching on dua. Indeed, dua is the greatest weapon a slave of Allah can have. Allahu Akbar. It is a beautiful link between the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah the Almighty. It is a beautiful link. Hadith is in Adabul Mufrad of Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah. Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu, he states that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said that whoever does not turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the narration goes along the lines of these words, whoever does not turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in dua, seeking, supplicating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah the Almighty is angered with that individual. Allahu Akbar. Allah the Almighty, He is angered. His anger is over that individual. And our powerful Maker, He states in the Noble Quran, وقال ربكم ادعوني استجب لكم ان الذين يستكبرون عن عبادتي سيدخلون جهنم داخرين وقال ربكم ادعوني استجب لكم. And he says, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وقال ربكم, your Lord says, ادعوني استجب لكم, turn to me, supplicate unto me, and I will answer your supplication. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informing us. Turn to me in supplication and I will answer your supplication. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي. And indeed those who scorn my worship, who turn away from supplicating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala out of pride, سَيَدْخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ دَاخِرِينَ. Indeed, they shall enter Jahannam humiliated. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. I wish to share with you all a few secrets in regard to dua. And this has been taught to us by our scholars, rahimahumullah. In regard to dua, number one, there are five aspects of dua being answered. See, most of us, the problem that we face is that we quickly lose hope. We quickly turn away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We turn to Allah the Almighty in dua. We ask Him once, twice, thrice, and then we give up. Allahu Akbar. We give up very easily. We aren't persistent in our dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these five things discuss on how a person's dua will inevitably be accepted as long as he asks for something that is halal, that is permitted, that is within the guidelines of Sharia. Every dua of ours, no doubt it will be answered under these five conditions or situations. Number one is that our dua will be accepted immediately, the minute we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I'm sure each and every one of us, we have that personal experience that we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the dua was immediately answered. It is immediately answered. But don't forget that your du'as are inevitably always answered as long as you ask for something that is within the guidelines of Sharia. So number one, it is immediately answered. Number two, the answer is a bit delayed. Or your du'a, the response for your du'a is a bit delayed. And there are many examples to quote in regard to that. Beautiful examples. If you were to take the life of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, Allahu Akbar, I'll quickly run through the story. Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, he was taken from his beloved father Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam by his very own brothers. His own brothers, they took him and went and dumped him in a well. So let me ask you a question. A father who loves his son dearly and the son who loves his father in return, they have both been separated. The father does not know where his beloved son is. The son is a young boy. He wants to get back to his family. He's in the well. Don't you think that both of these prophets would have been in sincere dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The father, no doubt, he would have been praying, Ya Allah, return my son back to me safe and sound. The son, on the other hand, in the pit of that dark well, he would have been praying to Allah, Ya Allah, return me back to my family. Both of them were in prayer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about their story in the Noble Quran, where Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam, the father of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, he says, Allah the Almighty, he states in the Noble Quran in Surah Yusuf, وَبِيَضَّتْ عَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْحُزْنِ فَهُوَ قَضِيمٌ وَبِيَضَّتْ عَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْحُزْنِ فَهُوَ كَظِيمٌ. That Ya'qub alayhi salatu wasalam's eyes went white, i.e. he went blind out of grief and out of sadness. Because فَهُوَ كَظِيمٌ, he was suppressing the grief, he was suppressing the sadness, he went blind. Allahu Akbar. And then he says, قَالَ إِنَّمَا أَشْكُو بَثِّي وَحُزْنِي إِلَى اللَّهِ. That I only complain my grief and my sorrow to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَعْلَمُ مِنَ اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. And then Ya'qub alayhi salatu wasalam informs the brothers, informs the people around him, I know things that you don't know that have been taught to me by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was patient. فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ, he says. He was patient. He was praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the answer did not come immediately. A prophet of Allah making dua. But the response has been delayed. And look at the amazing part of the story. He is praying to Allah, Ya Allah, bring me back my son. The son is praying to Allah, Ya Allah, take me back to my family. And what happens? The well was in the same locality. They were all in one locality. They're both praying to get back together. And what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do? A caravan comes and they take Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam further away. Further away, Allahu Akbar. They are praying to get back and Allah the Almighty is taking them further away. And what happens? He is sold as a slave. He's sold as a slave. And he's taken far away. And then the woman of that particular house he was working in, she tried to seduce him. She tried to seduce him. And he was successful in the trial, in that particular trial. He did not give in. He was blamed for something that he did not do. And then he says, رَبِّ السِّجْنُ وَأَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا يَدْعُونَنِي إِلَيْهِ. Ya Allah, prison is more beloved to me than what they are calling me to, i.e. zina. Prison is much more beloved to me. And that dua was immediately answered. Allahu Akbar. He says, Ya Allah, I prefer to be in prison than to answer to their call. They're calling me to something that is haram. That dua was immediately answered. And Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam was imprisoned for a long time. And after that, Allah the Almighty makes him the king. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings his family back and joins them. This, my dear respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam, teaches us that Allah's master plan is going on behind the scenes. And our weak, futile minds cannot perceive the great plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We fail to perceive the great plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And due to that,
we think Allah the Almighty is not answering our du'as. Say for example, we want to get married. We are praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, I wish to get married, please, I need a good spouse. You keep praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then comes about a proposal. A proposal comes, and now you're going to go see the girl, and you pray to Allah again, Ya Allah, I pray that this marriage works out, and let it work out in a beautiful manner. But then what happens when you go and have a look at the girl, work on the proposal, it breaks. And then you're disheartened. You're thinking, oh, I prayed so much to Allah, but Allah the Almighty is not answering my dua. But remember, perhaps there was some khair in it. Allah the Almighty, His master plan is working behind the scenes. Do not give up. Do not lose hope. Be persistent in your dua. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a million or a billion ways to bring it to you. Allahu Akbar. We at times, we map out something. We think that, you know what? This has to come to me through this route. And then if it does not come that way, we lose hope. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a million, a billion routes to bring that thing to you. Allah says in the Noble Quran, وَمَن يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. That as for the one who fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, adopts taqwa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cause an out from any situation. He may be in a problem, Allah the Almighty will bring him out of that problem. وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. And whoever relies on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah the Almighty is sufficient for him. And Allah says in the previous ayah too, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide him from sources unimaginable. Allahu Akbar. So number one, your dua is immediately answered. Number two, the response comes a bit delayed, but do not lose hope, because inevitably it is going to come. Allah knows what is good for you. Allah knows how to bring it about for you, because Allah is the best of planners. Number three, is that at times you may be asking for something and you'll get the exact opposite to it. Allahu Akbar. I'll give you an example. The mother of Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam. The mother of Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam. The scholars of tafasir, they mention that her name was Hanna. She prays to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, bless me with a son. Rabbi inni nadartu laka ma fi batni muharraran fataqabbal minni. She prays to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a son. And what does she get? A daughter. Allahu Akbar. She prays for a son so that she can devote him completely in the servitude of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But she got the exact opposite. She gets a baby girl. And then what happens? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the best of planners, through that blessed girl, Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam, comes about. She gives birth to a great prophet, Jesus, Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah the Almighty, His plan is in play. We are too weak to perceive this great plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So at times, you may ask for something, you get the exact opposite, but keep your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah knows what is best for you. The final two, is that at times when you seek dua, when you ask for something, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala averts a calamity. A calamity was about to, you're asking for something that is going to be disastrous in your life, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala averts it away from you. This is also a way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers your dua. And finally, my dear respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam, is that at times your dua may not be answered in this world, but inevitably Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer it in the akhirah. Allah will inevitably answer it in the eternal life of the akhirah. So with that we conclude, and let us be persistent in our dua. Let us not give up hope. Let us keep turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and pray earnestly. Because the more conviction we have, the sooner the response will be from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So do not ever lose hope. Turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Keep asking dua from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in, keep knocking on the door of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and inevitably you will get a response. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of our sins, and may He the Almighty accept all of our good deeds, and may He make us or help us make the best out of this month of Ramadan as if it is our last month of Ramadan, and may He unite us in the gardens of Jannah just as how He united us here tonight with our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وآخر دعوايا عن الحمد لله رب العالمين جزاكم الله خير.